filling my pockets with anything that was free, regardless of whether or not I really liked it or needed it, walking countless blocks in flip-flops to save $5 on valet parking.
Ma'am?
I'm gonna be mom.
Yes?
Okay, mình ở đây.
10 phút nữa.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Employing duct tape instead of professionals to repair things like leaking pipes, busted shoe straps, and fractured bones. Meeting friends at a restaurant for dinner, ordering a glass of water. Tap is fine, thanks. I love the tap in this city.
I love the tap in this city.
How I'm really not hungry.
I'm listening to actually. How to make money. You're badass at making money. This is funny video.
My mouth in a blur. Choosing between phone service and health insurance. Spending excruciating amounts of time purchasing anything, from a TV to a bedspread to a wooden spoon, in order to thoroughly investigate every possibility of a cheaper option, a forthcoming sale, a coupon code, or to entertain the question, is this something I could perhaps make myself? If I'd put the same amount of time and focus that I put into freaking out about not having money, cutting back my expenses, finding the deals, haggling, researching, returning, refunding, redeeming, rerouting, rebating, into actually making money, I would have been driving a car with working windshield wipers years before I actually did it. This making money thing is not about never again making wise, informed purchases, or rejoicing in a good sale, or filling up on bread. It's about giving yourself the options and the permission to be, do, and have whatever lights you up, instead of acting like a victim of your circumstances. It's about not pretending everything is cool. I love having three roommates, none of whom know how to use a sponge or a goddamn broom, instead of focusing on making more money to afford yourself your own place for fear you'll be judged or you'll suck at it or that it'll be too hard or no fun or out of your reach. It's about creating the wealth that affords you the life you'd love to live instead of settling for what you think you can get. The human ability to rationalize, defend, and accept our self-imposed drama is bananas, especially because we all have the power within us to choose and create realities that totally kick ass. We see it all the time with people who are in miserable or even abusive relationships. He's just so sad and sorry after he cheats on me. It breaks my heart. Plus, the makeup sex is super hot. We see it when people insist on staying in jobs they hate. I spend my lunch breaks weeping in the stairwell, I'm so miserable. But the health insurance is amazing. Meanwhile, their spirit and their time on this earth are quickly swirling down the drain. Time wasted rationalizing the mediocre could be time spent creating the magnificent. You have one glorious and brief shot at being the you that is you on planet Earth, and the power to create whatever reality you desire. Why not be the biggest, happiest, most generous, and fully realized humanoid you can be? After some 40 plus years of scraping by, I finally could no longer bear hearing myself say my mantras of choice. I can't afford it, and I don't know what I want to do. Or to continue living in places so crappy and small that I could sit on the toilet, answer the door, and fry an egg all at the same time. It was like living on a boat,
on a toadstool.
I could no longer sit back and watch all these other people out there kicking butt, making great money doing what they loved, treating their pals to fancy dinners, donating more than $5 and a thank you note to charities they loved, traveling the world in luxury, wearing shoes that no stranger had worn before, basically living the life I wanted to live. I was just as smart, talented, charming, well-groomed. What the hell was my problem? What was I waiting for? No matter how much I complained or freaked out or tried to convince myself that my present rickety life was as good as it could, should, or would get, deep down, I knew I was meant for and wanted bigger things. I'd get all excited hearing about someone's cool job.